All right, people love Miguel in This Is Us. John Huertas has been with us before and talked about a variety of things. We're going to get to a play that's real important to him in just a minute, an invitation to you to participate in that play. We were just talking about it. This show, people just love out of their minds. And do you find that when people approach you, it's not just like, oh, you're on that show? I'm sure it's much more of an exchange than that.
Some people usually tell me, most people say, wow, you're so much younger. Because I play the older Miguel so much, they think that I'm older. And they see my face and they go, wow, you're actually my age.
I think somebody was telling, maybe Chrissy, saying a lot of times the exchange with the viewers, tears. I mean, people are crying about how affected they are by the show.
Well, I think because my character is probably the least liked character on the show, it's usually anger for me.
Okay. Like
furrowed brows.
Yeah.
But it's starting to get better. I mean, the writers have done a great job with turning the character around.
Right.
So it's good.
When you see older you there, the years are going to be kind. That's a pretty good preview. Is it weird?
It's a little weird.
Yeah.
It's got me thinking, what am I going to cut off at the pass?
Right.
Started talking to surgeons already.
Okay,
Some consultation. No, I'm just kidding. Yeah, it's fine.
You look distinguished.
You look distinguished. Yeah.
No, thank you. Thank you.
We're going to look at a clip, and then we're going to talk all about this play. This is from This Is Us.
Hey, it's Miguel. I'm not waking you, am I?
No, Miguel, you fixed the fridge.
Yeah, listen, Kevin's here. He's fine, but he's had a little too much to drink.
Okay, I'm on my way.
No, it's okay. I've got him. And he's sleeping, so, he's fine here, really.
Miguel, thank you for all you're doing to help. You're too good to us. We don't deserve you.
Oh, that's so nice. All right, let's talk about this play. And you told me an interesting story, part of a trilogy, and that you initially were going to be involved in the first play.
I auditioned for the first play, which is called Blade to the Heat, which ran at the Mark Taper. It premiered at the Public in New York. And I had just moved here, and I was thinking, I want to do TV and film. I've been dreaming about being on television for years since I was in second grade. And so I auditioned for this play. I got a call back. I got another call back. And then I had this last call back, and I didn't show up because I thought, I just want to do TV. Mm-hmm. And then it ran and did so well at the Mark Taper, and I kicked myself for years about, you know, not taking the chance to get into this play. And now this... The second version, this is like a dream, like to be able to get on stage and play this, you know, character that I was hopefully going to play back then. It's been amazing, and the process has been amazing. I love being back on stage. Members Only is such a great kind of, it's a great story about what it's like to be a guy who's in a kind of a macho kind of existence, a boxer who is harboring this secret of being gay, and it takes place in the 80s around the AIDS epidemic time period when right now we haven't seen a lot about that, so we're kind of revisiting that a little bit.
A local playwright,
Oliver Mayer. He's a professor at USC, teaches playwriting there. He wrote Blade to the Heat. His wife, Marlene Forte, is in the play with me, and she is amazing, and she plays my love interest, and which is probably weird to Oliver. I don't know.
but what did Oliver...
He wrote it.
But what did Oliver say to you when you came back to do this? He recalled way back when.
He recalled when I auditioned for the play. He was super excited and was like, I was excited to meet you back then. I'm excited for you to be in the play. I think we talked about it on set. Marlene and I were working on a series together. And he came to the set to visit her. And we talked about this 8 years ago when he just had the idea of writing the second version of the story, of the trilogy, which is Members Only.
Why do you want audiences to see it? What do you think is important about it?
I think it's really important to show that, you know, the times that we live in now with, the different types of sexual orientations that there are. There's, you know, things aren't black and white. And I think if this world would be a lot better, a much better place, if people didn't think in black and white, if we lived in the gray area. So that nothing's right, nothing's wrong. There is right and wrong, but there's, you know, as far as, you know, a man and a woman, that can be just jumbled around depending on how someone was born. And so my character in particular goes through his own journey in this play. which is, you know, talking about sexual fluidity. And I think that that's important to see that, that what we know today is not always, you know, it's not solid. It, you know, things are fluid. And that's what the play, I think, deals with. And it also deals with the AIDS epidemic, which is very important to kind of, you know, teach people the history that weren't there in the right. 80s. Teach people the history of where we started and where we are now with regards to HIV and AIDS.
All right, well, tell people the TV stuff, This Is Us, you know, is Tuesdays at 9 on NBC.
That's true.
And Members Only is running now through November 18th, LA Theater Center. Ticket information is latc.org. Good to have you this morning.
Thanks.
Thank you, John.
Thank you.